executive session to discuss personnel matters.
Motion for executive session. Mr. McAdoo, want to say it? Motion to appoint AJ McAdoo, roadmaster, Donovan Township, from now to the end of the year, at a rate of $500 per month, roughly 3 hours per day. It doesn't have to be, and that's just something that you're working out, that works out for you. He has no experience whatsoever. The motion includes that we reimburse the standard IRS mileage rate, and, and we'll give a monthly, you know, we'll give a monthly report to the board meeting of the activity in the road department.
Any questions? How you vote? Public comment?
Good, Jake. He doesn't have anything to do with this, so I just wanted to come back to it, but I just wanted to say in an open meeting what I was discussing up there while you guys were on, so when you're done, I'd like to address that at some point.
How you vote?
Dave?
Yes.
Doug?
Yes.
Zach?
Yes.
I want one of these books.
I understand there's some questions about personnel and activities in the township. At my direction, I had Tammy put together a summary of some of the requests and some of the things that we have been working on in the township as far as personnel. Mr. Kearney, since you're involved in all this, you're here anyways, and we're paying anyways, would you want to, take a look at this and see if this means anything to you?
So you just want to kind of summarize?
Okay, this looks like it basically lists out the various regular requests that are at issue and subject to some of the questions that the crowd has. I'm Mike Kearney. I was the one that was appointed a couple months ago to assist with the open records office. You serve there until the board changes their mind, and it goes back to them, I guess. But essentially, between June 14th and June 24th, so a period of a little over 40 days, 5 weeks or so, there's 18 requests made to the township, in which Tammy, as the open records officer, had to respond to, had to deal with. That's in addition to multiple emails back and forth between the requesters. So just to give you an idea, Tammy was responding, she was not going to us every time. It's my understanding that if you go back through our bills, and you guys have had the opportunity to do that, there would not be a lot of right to know bills from our office that was charged against the township previous to this June 14th time period. The issue is, coming from Tammy's standpoint, is as the open records officer, she would be the one that's liable if something went wrong. If she responded improperly, if records went missing, if she just let someone come in and take a look at stuff and things went missing, it would be on her, because as the records officer, it's under her watch. If she gives out privileged information documents, and a lot of these requests dealt with privileged information, including lawsuits, open-end lawsuits, no offense to Tammy, but she's not an attorney. Just like I'm not an engineer. Just like engineers rely, or the supervisors rely on solicitors, engineers to do professional work, and they listen to that. So basically that's what Tammy was doing here. So when we reviewed things and she contacted us, she was doing so within the law, within her right to protect herself. Because ultimately, if she gave up documents, of which we came across 9, 10, 11 or so, there were questionable and foul, she would be liable. Those attorneys who have the privilege with these, with the supervisors of the township in their capacity, if there was documentation that was released that ultimately hurt the township, hurt the attorneys in their lawsuits, Tammy would be the one that's liable. So that's essentially how our office got involved.
I have a question for you. Some of the information that was requested, you said was privileged information. In order for us to release that information, do we not have to get approvals of the attorneys who granted that information?
Yeah, and when I say records are privileged, I understand that that's under appeal and that will be determined. The township has taken that position. Yes, if the township has released documentation that is privileged without notifying the third party of the privilege.
Did you contact any of those attorneys?
We contacted the attorney handling one of the lawsuits.
And who was that attorney?
I believe his name is Mahoney was the last name. I don't know the first, it might have been John Mahoney.
And Mr. Mahoney gave an opinion on his documents?
Correct.
Were there any other documents?
There was other documents between the previous solicitor and the township. Dennis Maple was the solicitor.
Dennis Maple, was he requested to give an opinion on whether his documents should be released?
We notified him that the township was considering releasing the document.
And we were not replying to the opinion.
Today we have heard that. But Mason, just to give you an understanding, that's how our office got involved. It's not dealing with simple requests. These are extensive requests. The Tammy had questions.
Can you read through those?
Okay, I'll read through a few of these. June 14, 2016, a request by email for gas and oil ordinance and contract between West Virginia PUC, or West, is that West Virginia PUC, and West Alexander Borough. A week later, June 21st, request by email copy of June 8 minutes, copies of any and all correspondence and meeting minutes, plus copies of the lawyer fees concerning the lawsuit with the township, was brought into dealing with Hall versus Ronald Ritchie, concerning the paper rally, and the deed signed by David Ely. 2 days later, request by email for copy of all minutes reflecting the appointment of the Donald supervisors as planning committee. Copies of all invoices of Perry Maniego of Environmental Planning and Design LLC. Copies of all invoices for Gary Sweat for the past 12 months. Copies of all correspondence between any and all supervisors. Attorney Sweat, the secretary, treasurer of the township, Carolyn Yeagle, concerning proposed zoning. All correspondence shown through emails, letters, and texts. The following day, June 24th, request submitted for all purposes for Gary Sweat for the past 12 months. From June 2015 to June 2016, requesting all documents electronically. Same day, request for form submitted for copies of all invoices for Carolyn Yeagle and environmental planning and design for the past 12 months. Same day, request form submitted for copies of all minutes reflecting the appointment of the Donovan Township supervisors and the planning committee. Same day, request form submitted for all copies correspondence between Gary L. Sweat, employees of Gary L. Sweat Law Office, David Ely, Doug Teagarden, Zach Prescott, Carolyn Yeagle, Donovan Township Secretary, Donovan Township Treasurer. All correspondence shown through emails, letters, and texts. Requesting all documents electronically. A week later, July 5th, request form submitted for all correspondence between texts and emails, minutes, and bills between Donald Township supervisors, Township secretaries, Gary Sweat Law Office regarding the cease and desist letter sent to Kathleen Wrightcroft on June 16, 2016, requesting copies electronically using Chrome equipment. July 7th, 2016, showed up unannounced to inspect minute books, stayed for 3 hours. July 15th, request by email to make copies of the correspondence that were presented at the July 13th Township meeting. July 18th, reviewed correspondence, there for 45 minutes. 3 days later, July 21st, reviewed record, there for 2 hours, 45 minutes. 3 days later, again, July 24th, request form submitted for two ordinances that have not been codified by Carolyn Yeagle, last year pending. Requesting to make copies electronically and using their own equipment. July 24th, request form submitted for any and all bills from Gary L. Sweat Office to Donald Township from July and August. Any and all bills from Gary L. Sweat to Donald Township from June 2014 to June 2015. Requesting to make their own copies. Same day, request form submitted for any and all bills that are submitted to Donald Township in the months July and August by Environmental Planning and Design, Karen Nagel, or Adam Schwartz. Requesting to make their own copies. Electronic. Same day, July 24th. Request form submitted for any and all correspondence, including emails, texts, or phone calls regarding drivers, water extension, involving the supervisors, Mr. Schwartz, the office staff, Tom Bibby, and the township engineers. Also, any estimates, feasibility studies, and bills requesting to make current copies electronically. July 24th, request form submitted for any and all correspondence or info regarding the town zoning workshop on May 27, 2015, requesting to make current copies electronically. August 3rd, 2016, reviewed records, 1 hour and 45 minutes. Do you want me to continue or is it continue? Okay, back to June 24th. Request form submitted for electronic copies for all invoices, payments, dues, and checks written to over the past Carol Sweat Law Office, Attorney Gary Sweat, Environmental Planning Design, and Carolyn Lee. Also electronic copies of the zoning proposals from Mackin Engineering and Environmental Planning and Design LLC. June 24th, same day. Request forms submitted for electronic copies be sent via email of all the meeting minutes, motions, and ordinances. So all the meeting minutes, motions, and ordinances, along with any and all documentation from the supervisors, have the authority or right to make themselves a planning committee and or agency. Electronic copies be sent via email of all correspondence, including letters, emails, and text messages between any and all of the planning committee and or agency, the planning commission, the Donovan Township Secretary, the Donovan Township Treasurer, any and all Donovan Township Office personnel, any and all supervisors, any and all attorneys associated with the Gary L. Sweat Law Office, and any and all correspondence with any and all environmental and design over the past 12 months. July 7th, showed up on announcement inspecting the books. July 13th, requested by email an additional request on June 24th to include inspecting and making digital copies of all ordinances and resolutions that govern Donovan Township. As well as inspecting the planning commission official meeting minute books. July 21st, showed up with your records 2 hours 45 minutes. July 28th, 2016, requested by email to inspect the original documents that had already been provided as copies on July 21st, including invoices from Gary Sweat for proof of payment, invoices from Environmental Planning Design for proof of payment, zoning proposals from Mackin Engineering, also Environmental Planning Design, LLC. August 3rd, 2016, reviewed records 1 hour 40 minutes, and then today, requested minutes for the last 24 years.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. How dare the taxpayer want to know what's going on?
They have every right to.
Yeah.
They have every right to. The law says they have the right to. We're just giving you an idea of why Tammy, in her capacity, cannot do that on her own and has the right, under the law, to request the assistance of supervisors, hiring other personnel, including this solicitor. So that's essentially what has brought us into this.
Hey, what was the request from Makel's office? I'm there. I know my answer would be...
Not a request. It was putting on notice that there was documentation requested that we responded was privileged. They then appealed it to the Right to Know Appeals Board.
Were you waiting for a response from us?
We gave you until, I think, a week ago.
Okay. Because the answer is it's your privilege, not the attorney's.
Yeah, but the law says that we have to put you on notice, and we're giving you the privilege and the courtesy of that.
Were you waiting for us to tell you something?
Yes, we were.
Well, we released it after you guys had responded. We gave her what she wanted.
Oh, okay.
So, but again, under the law,
Yeah. Well, it's your privilege.
Correct.
We paid Mr. Mickle's firm to advise us at that time that he was our attorney.
Okay. At the time?
Mr. Mickle was our attorney for many years.
Yes. I know. I used to come to your meetings. I worked with you, Doug. You remember?
This privilege was on the Richie case.
Yeah, well, so what I'm saying is, I'm explaining to how we had to get involved, because under the law, if there's protected privilege information, we have to...
I understand all that. I'm saying that
was unavoidable. Once that request comes in,
I understand
that's
that.
An unavoidable law.
I just wanted to answer, because the impression I got was, as I'm sitting here, it sounded like Mr. Teagarden was saying you were waiting for a response from us, but I don't remember any request.
We did send a request.
What did you ask us to respond to?
We said, if you have any objection to us releasing this, please let us know by then. I don't remember the date. But yeah, again, like I said, it's a third party request we're putting on notice, but we're given the chance to say, if you object. The attorney for the insurance company in the open matter, the Hall Ritchie matter, responded with
his belief
that it was attorney Brian Klovich of settlement negotiations, as it's an open case. He requests that we do not release the information.
Okay.
So to date, we have not released that information.
But we didn't have any objection.
No. Yeah. So again, once the taxpayer, which has a right to request that documentation, once it comes in motion, though, she has to follow the rules. And then if she requests us, those letters have to go out. We have to review all the documentation, make sure that she does not release something. Because if she releases it without asking us, she's in trouble. If she then relies on us, which is her right to do so, and then we tell her that they can release it, and it was privileged, a third party that had that right without putting it on notice, then we get in trouble.
I just wanted to make it clear.
I'm explaining to them how
I didn't miss anything. We said nothing, so it was okay.
I'm not trying to throw you into the bus. I'm pointing out how our office will get involved and how the bill will come. When you have a lawsuit that's been going on for multiple years, that you have a stack of documents, she's not a trained guy, she's going to turn it over to the solicitor to look at it and to review all the documents to make sure. And then when we do find things that are possibly privileged, we then have to put a third party on notice.
Sure.
And then it gets objected to, and now we have to go to mediation and explain why we are protecting them. So those are all costs that are being borne by the taxpayers, which is not their fault, and it's not the township.
Right, nobody's fault. Right.
She has every right to do that.
Again, no objection.
Yeah, so that's kind of how the bills can get backed up.
Well, wait a minute, we weren't done.
In correspondence, we got quite a stack this month. We got proof from Principal Energy that they had pumped out their tanks up on Route 40. We have a letter from Matt Novelli, who has confirmed that the status of the second entrance to his campground has been graded in. He is asking us if we want to have stones put on, if we want to stone put on, need to contact him directly, but the grading has been done. Maybe we have a roadmaster talk with them, if it needs to be stoned at the back entrance to the campground bus.
What campground?
In the valleys over here at the interstate. They went over hooked on the old way to Burger Road. We have a letter here from certified mail from Lennon Smith and Solaray engineers. Regards to a stream bank stabilization at on Dutch Fork Stream. You might have listened. Yeah, you gotta look at this. Might be something you already have. Bulletin from PSATS. We have an earth disturbance inspection report on Valor General, which is open. We have a letter from Range Resources concerning the Michael Harris property. We have a malfunctioning sewage system complaint. This came in anonymously, is that correct, Tammy? On the property out on Dry Ridge. And if we get a complaint someone's septic system is malfunctioning, we are required under the law to notify the sewage council. And they're doing an inspection, and if they find it to be in fault, then these people are just going to pay $100 on it. And if not, if it's okay, at least we eat the $100. We have to cost us money to have it done. That's on the boroughs. Boroughs.
Assuming that $100 be borne by the person that filed their complaint,
this case is not meant as an anonymous complaint. I don't agree with it, but it's a way to word about it. We have all kind of appeals on real estate. Someplace I read in the Donovan Township now assesses real estate. Tammy, do we assess any real estate? I didn't think we did. Okay. Someone said that we did, but I'm not sure about that. Okay, there's a lot of assessment appeals, a whole list of them if anybody's interested. Washington County Planning Commission is putting together a joint purchasing agreement asking us to join. We have a letter from Southwest regarding some of the property. I'm not sure what see if there's the Scott Schofield pad in West Finley Township. This is the Redevelopment Authority of Washington County. Talks about some low interest programs they have for loaning out money to fix blight. We could use some of that. We got a letter from West Penn Power, says they're going to be doing some brush trimming. Consol Energy, certified mail, talking about the Consol operation East Finley Township. Another one from Southwest regarding the Bernard McCulley pad, West Finley Township. We have a Pennsylvania One Call letter. Another correspondence from PSATS.
You have freedom.
And some things from the USDA on the spread of rabies. Speaking of which, there has been a request to put on a cat clinic here. If any of you people would like to be involved in the cat clinic, or looking for someone to run it.
How you
do? People come in, they get their animals fixed and get shots, and
be a good idea.
And very low cost. If you're interested, we did here a few years ago, it was very successful. We've already made contact with them. If somebody's interested in heading that up, you want Kami?
Well, yeah, because there's lots of cats here.
There are lots of cats. We need to get the cats spayed and neutered, so there won't be so many of them.
That'd be good.
Okay, there is a footnote here that went off the old McDonald pad. We were drilling down there. Who's drilling there? Frames. Moving off the old McDonald pad down on 40. EQT, regarding the JT Farms property, East Penley Township. We got a correspondence from Kathy Prescott, who was asking for members to be appointed to the Joint Planning Commission of Claysville Borough and McDonald Township. And they meet about how many times a year? Four times a year. They go through ordinances and look at comprehensive plans, and look at our comprehensive plan and try to make sure that we're trying to follow it. We need two people. Can they both be from Donegal, and we need two people from the borough?
We don't have a borough.
We need one from the borough and one from Donegal. So if anyone is interested, the next meeting is when? 18th of September. So by the next meeting, if you would kindly give us your name, we would get you appointed this thankless, no pay position, right? But they are important, they do go through them and make sure we comply with our own plans. A letter from Smith Butts attorney, representing the Washoe County Machine Guns, and is basically putting us on record that they're intended to develop their entire real estate, and they're including a map of what they're planning to put the different ranges and so forth. We have a letter regarding Washington County Town Hall, and this is where they're having meetings to discuss the assessment, which I guess today was the deadline to have your assessment appeal in. We have another thing from Range. During the Robert Jones pass, this may interest you in the one on the ridge on the bridge. This whole lot of stuff here on this one, you might well see this if you haven't seen it. Anybody lives out in the neighborhood, the Robert Jones pad. We have a letter from Judith Yusko, who lives up on Yusko Lane, and she's talked about various things in here regarding our road, Yusko Drive, and it's worth looking at. If you don't know where Yusko Drive is, I didn't know for a long time, but Union Township Road is the bus that little hook of old Route 40. And you're going up Route 40 and you go into Buffalo Township, there's a little hook of the old road. That's Yusko Drive. And we are supposed to maintain that. We don't maintain it very much, but it's ours. We have a letter from Ward Salt. You said they would like to bid. Have us bid for salt, 50 tons of salt for them, and that is here. One thing I do want to tell you about this forward correspondence, we did have people come in after the last meeting and request it. Luckily, we still had it mostly assembled. It is no, after tonight's meeting, it is no longer a folder. This stuff all gets put where it belongs in the files or thrown away as advertisements. So if you'd like to see it as a collection, you need to see it tonight, because tomorrow it will be in the little pieces. Other than that, that's all I have.
Motion to adjourn.
Tell the people to stay and talk and ask questions. Yeah, I'll second it.
Dave?
Yes.
Doug?
Yes.
Zach?
Yes.
I'll come here to tomorrow.
Folks, we'll stay here another 15 minutes or longer if you want. Anything you want to know about, if you want to take a look at documents, you want to look at them.